From its stark black and white opening to its bloody cliffhanger ending, Casino Royale makes a statement. This isn't the James Bond you remember. No punny one-liners, no ridiculous gadgets, no cartoonish henchmen. It's just Bond, his girl, his fists, and his wits against a world-class threat in the form of underworld banker Le Chiffre, played by Hannibal star Mads Mikkelsen. Consider this scene. In it, Bond's expert poker playing has bankrupted Le Chiffre, forcing the criminal to take drastic measures. He takes Bond hostage, strips him naked, and ties him to a bottomless chair. Then the torture begins. With a knotted rope, Le Chiffre repeatedly smacks Bond's most vulnerable and valued organ, trying to get Bond to give up the password that'll unlock his poker winnings. What follows isn't just one of Craig's best scenes as Bond. It tells you everything you need to know about this new, modern 007, and it makes it almost impossible not to fall in love with him. Here's what we mean. The old James Bond ended up in plenty of dangerous situations, but it rarely felt like he was ever in genuine trouble. For many fans, that was part of his charm. Whether he's strapped to a table with a laser heading towards his crotch, tossed in a tank full of sharks, or locked up in a North Korean prison, it's not a question of whether or not he'll survive, it's a matter of how. In Casino Royale's torture scene, things are different. Bond is trapped, and he doesn't just endure a few bruises or scratches. He takes a legitimate beating at Le Chiffre's hands. We've never seen 007 like this before. Stripped down, in pain, and completely helpless. He's exposed psychologically, too. He knows he's in a helpless situation. He knows there's no help coming, and that despite his prowess at the card table, he's overplayed his hand. He's worried about his love interest, Vesper Lind, and realizes that his affection for her exposed a weak spot that Le Chiffre can exploit. Physically, he's a mess. Mentally, he's a raw nerve. At one point, he finally loses his cool. His facade crumbles for a second, and all of his carefully suppressed anger bursts out.
No matter what you do, I'm not going to give you the password, which means your clients are going to hunt you down and cut you into little pieces of meat while you're still breathing.
Then, Bond loses. He doesn't miraculously break free of Le Chiffre's ropes. He doesn't dispatch the enemy using fancy doodads or near-supernatural fighting skills. He only survives because a mysterious third party interrupts, and because, as we learn later, Vesper bargained for his life. The implication is clear. This is a Bond who can be defeated. This is a Bond who can be broken. That changes everything. Craig's Bond isn't superhuman. He can die like everyone else. As a result, every action scene that Craig's Bond is in has real stakes. We've seen him fail before. Who's to say it couldn't happen again? Author Ian Fleming created 007. But as fans know, the James Bond of the books is very, very different from the one on the screen. Fleming's Bond is a cold, calculating killer who's fussy about particulars and driven by a pursuit of pleasure. When Sean Connery brought Bond to movie theaters, he added a masculine, sadistic edge. Later actors like Roger Moore and Pierce Brosnan layered aristocratic charm and a flippant sense of humor. For fans of the original books, the end result is almost unrecognizable.
Why did you break off the encounter with my pet python?
I discovered he had a crush on me.
Likewise, the older movies tended to borrow titles from Fleming's novels, but little else. For example, in the book, Moonraker is a missile, not a space shuttle. The same can't be said for Casino Royale, however. While the opening sequences in the Bahamas and Florida were created for the movie, most likely to pad out a short and efficient book, the rest of the film is remarkably faithful to the source material. This scene is no exception. While the corresponding moment in the Casino Royale novel lacks the movie's modern touches and takes place in a different setting, it's at Le Chiffre's villa, not an abandoned boat. The major beats are the same. Le Chiffre's monologue about the simplicity of torture is even directly adapted from Fleming's prose.
It's the simplest thing to cause more pain than a man can possibly enjoy.
Along with Craig's restrained performance, that goes a long way towards cementing the idea that Craig's Bond is also Fleming's Bond. Although, admittedly, there is a little bit of Connery's version mixed in, too. For casual fans, that was a fresh take on a character that started to grow a little stale. For diehards, it was something they'd been waiting to see for 44 years, and when it finally arrived, it didn't disappoint. Daniel Craig's Bond doesn't crack many jokes. In fact, it's hard to find a scene in which he even has a real, sincere smile. But in this scene, he does make one, and it's a doozy.
I've got a little itch. Down there.
To the right! To the right!
That's a far cry from Pierce Brosnan's Hollywood one-liners, or Roger Moore's goofy puns and dad jokes. Oh sure, it's a darkly funny moment. Craig's delivery is perfect, as is Mads Mikkelsen's exasperated reaction, but it's a different use of humor than we've seen in other James Bond movies. In the past, Bond seemed like he was performing for the movie's audience, delivering quips when no one else was around.
Backseat driver.
Here, the joke is another form of violence. Bond's hands are literally tied, but that doesn't stop him from fighting back. He just uses sarcasm instead of his Walther P99. It works, too. Bond's taunts get under Le Chiffre's skin, even though he's the one holding all the cards. When Bond laughs after making the joke, it's not because he's amused. It's the growl of a cornered animal warning its attacker to back off. We've already watched Bond show remarkable resilience during this scene. Now, we're seeing that he's so stubborn that he'll still make jokes even when his life is on the line. That's not funny, it's scary. And an excellent hint as to just how dangerous and committed Daniel Craig's version of James Bond really is. Thanks for watching. Click the links in our video to watch more from Netflix Film Club. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.